gates, all the people in it shall be subject to forced labor.
Mm-hmm.
Forced labor.
That's right.
You force them, yeah?
Okay.
They're slaving.
Yeah.
And shall work for you. If they refuse to make peace and they engage you in battle, lay siege to the city. When the Lord your God delivers it into your hand, put in the sword all the men in it. Kill all the men.
Yeah. Okay.
And they went on to say that, as for the women, the children,
let me see that verse.
And livestock and everything else in the city, you may take these as plunder for yourselves.
Yeah.
Okay. Plunder for yourselves.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And you may use the plunder the Lord your God give you from it. What do you may use your plunder? What does that mean?
Hold on. I should tell you. I should eat this while.
You may use the plunder for your. What does that mean?
No. Which verse is that?
Deuteronomy 20, 10 to 14.
No. Which one you just read about? You may use it.
Yeah, it's in. Go to 14.
14.
Yeah, 14. Yeah, 14. 14 says. Yeah. As for the women, children, livestock, and everything else in the city, you may take this as plunder for yourselves, and you may use the plunder the Lord your God gives you from your enemies. What does that to use your plunder? How do you use it?
It says eat the.
Huh? Sorry?
It says eat.
No, bro, I'm telling you.
So you're supposed to eat the women?
People that know Arabic. Every time they say
verse 14.
There's no marriage in it.
Which Bible is this one?
I'm telling you,
King James.
A lot of these people are
well, let's look up the Hebrew word. Let's see who's right. If it's NIV.
King James. King James.
Yeah.
So you may eat the women as well.
But that's what you're trying to say.
That's what he said.
No. You're saying you mentioned women. It doesn't mention women here, does it? It says spoil. It doesn't say women.
Okay, what the order spoil? Now this one put into context. They put into context. King James is again. You can get language. He uses old fashioned language that you know that's it.
No, but look, the root word is to eat. So they've the way they translate it is not quite right. Yeah, it says eat, you feed with food.
This one is got this one. Millions of people reading these millions around the world. It's a Christian. That's not one Bible. Millions, go and check it.
Yeah.
Millions are reading. So they are wrong.
But
the millions are
it's a translation.
It's a translation as well, King James.
It's
a translation. So many errors in King James.
But King James, the Hebrew word, they translated it more accurately. Because it actually says it's eat.
No. John 3, 6, begotten. Tell me Hebrew and begotten.
We're talking about...
I'm telling you something that you know, that the King James has got many defects as well.
Right.
Many defects, I see. So it's a Bible. That means that this is wrong. Thank you.
Yeah, but we're talking about the Hebrew. We're talking about the Hebrew
word.
My
neighbor will tell you, no, this is the Bible. This is what they use. There you go.
We're talking about the Hebrew word here. The Hebrew word is eat. Food, dine, feed. That's all eating, isn't it? So he doesn't say you should eat the women.
Look, I didn't say eat the women.
No, but that's trying to imply.
But that's what the Bible is there. This Bible, millions of people use, you know, this. Yeah? Revised and the Revised Standard Version of God. I mean, they are wrong. So which one is true Bible?
No.
You got the King James in there. You got others there.
It's what the manuscript says. But don't you keep saying the Arabic, isn't it? With the Quran? Isn't that what you say? In the Quran, it has to be the Arabic, isn't it?
The Arabic, yeah.
So I'm bringing the Hebrew, so what's the difference?
You mean the Hebrew? Jesus spoke Hebrew? What did Jesus speak?
No, he did.
What's the Hebrew Bible?
He did speak Hebrew.
What's the Hebrew Bible then? Huh? What is the Bible? The Hebrew?
No, it got destroyed, didn't it?
Arabic.
So Aramaic, that's the thing. We got many, that's the thing.
Yeah.
See, we got...
But you realize you're diverse. No,
I'm giving an example, that's the thing. So this thing in your Bible is in the Bible, that's the thing. So, you know, slavery is in the Bible. So what's the big deal? So if it's Islam in the time of war, you know, they
But you should have given us the one about you can sleep with the women, though, and not marry them. That's what we're waiting for.
Where is it? Where you get that from? He didn't read all of it. Have you read all of us?
No, we read down. No, it was a wife.
Read all of it.
So there's a part which doesn't say wife.
He didn't read all of it. He come out and said, you should have sex with a slave woman. That's what he said.
But
you quote things out of context.
Yeah. But I'm trying to find the part where he says, it doesn't say wife. You know where that is?
Your Bible said that, when you go, see, this thing I quoted here too. Why don't you believe in that then?
Like
that
what?
It's not he. This 21.
Yeah.
Yeah, why don't you believe what it says? 21. Yeah, when he said, when you go to war, listen to me. When you go to war against your enemies, and the Lord your God delivers them into your hands, and you take captives. Remember, you take captives.
Yeah, that's
it's
fine.
A captive.
Yeah.
Remember, it's not a woman that you know that you met in the street or you went to the pit. It's a captive.
Yeah, but it doesn't say anything about selling them, though.
No. I'm not about selling. I'm taking you.
Okay, that's fine.
You are forcing them.
Yeah,
you are forcing to marry them. It's a forced marriage. Not anybody.
Okay, read that. Read the part about forced marriage.
No, listen to me. Okay, listen to me. When you go to war against your enemies, and the Lord, when you go to war against your enemies, remember the enemies. The woman is an enemy. And the Lord your God delivers them in your hands.
Mm.
And you take captives. Mm-hmm. Let's say you killed all the men. If you notice among the captives a beautiful woman and attracted to her, you may take her as your wife.
Okay.
When you stop that, what comes to your mind?
There's no marriage in there. What is marriage?
Let's make it now. Mm. Go to war against their enemy.
Mm.
They kill all the men.
Yeah.
And one of the army men, let's say general, saw a beautiful woman among the captives. The two captives.
Yeah.
Remember, they killed all the men?
Yes.
The woman are captives and the children.
Mm-hmm.
And they noticed a beautiful woman among the captives.
Yeah.
The Bible said he can go and take that woman as a wife.
That's fine.
Against her will.
That doesn't say that.
But it says, your enemy is a captive.
But a captive is not going to willingly go.
Thank you. This is common sense.
I'm captive. I'm not going
to tell you. If we talk to atheists or no Muslim, they will tell you it's a captive. It's an enemy.
Yeah, because the atheists don't read the next verses, do they?
No, before you go read the next verse, you say. But the first thing we know that it's an enemy. And it's a captive. Captive is an enemy. You agree that?
I mean, you're captive you're not there by choice.
Thank you. Thank you very much. That's what I'm saying.
Yes, we know that.
Yeah, but don't say that you think you're talking as if the woman will willingly.
What's the rest of
Keep reading.
So the woman, say, you may take her as your wife if you're attached to her. Bring her into your home and make her shave her head, trim her nails, and put aside the clothes she was wearing when captured. After she has lived in your house and mourned her father and mother for a full month, remember, you've already killed her parents.
Keep going.
Then you may go to her and be her husband, and she shall be your wife.
Right. Celebration.
If you are pleased with her,
if you are pleased with her,
let her go wherever she wishes. You must not sell her or treat her as a slave.
Is that captive?
Since you have dishonored her.
Is that captive?
No, you're right.
Is that captive?
But
you don't.
She doesn't have a choice.
Thank you.
Is she a captive?
One sec. If she says no, he'll kill her.
Thank you.
Really? Where? Give me a Bible verse. Any Bible verse.
She says no, then she'll remain a slave.
Bring every Bible verse. Any Bible verse.
No, it didn't say read it.
If you are pleased with her. What if I'm not pleased with her?
No, if you're pleased with her.
You have to let her go. And you can't sell her.
You can't sell her either.
Okay, if I'm not pleased with her.
But slave is not the same way.
If I'm not pleased with her, what happens? Tell me that.
Just read the verse.
Thank you, that's it.
In
what way?
When you're thinking about slave,
but in what
in
way?
The Bible, I'm telling you, when you're thinking about slave, you're thinking about probably what happened in the transatlantic slavery with all the beating and everything.
We're not thinking about that.
There's strict laws about being a slave.
Locked up in is captivated. That's a slave.
That's what you think. Yeah, exactly.
So what's a slave? Tell me.
A slave in the Bible could be.
What is it?
That's what I'm telling you.
It wasn't
just a thing where you're a slave, you're held against your will, and you can't.
So what is the slave then?
Tell us what is a slave.
That's what I said. I could be a slave if I even owe this guy money and I wanted to work.
But you don't. She doesn't owe anything to him.
Yeah, but I'm telling you, I'm giving you a definition of what slavery is in the Bible. There's numerous reasons of slavery.
Can she go out of her own free will and leave?
Yes, she can.
He didn't say anything.
You can only set her free if you're pleased with her.
Exactly. That's what it means.
If you're not pleased with her.
If you are pleased with her, you can do what you want. If you're not pleased with her, then she stays.
No, she can go where she will.
Now read it again.
Alright, verse 14. And it shall be, if thou have no delight in her, then thou shalt let her go whither she will, but thou shalt not sell her at all for money. Thou shalt not make merchandise of her, because thou hast humbled her.
Okay, if I'm not pleased with her, I can let her go.
Yes.
Okay, fair enough.
But the man is calling the shots.
The initial thing is she had no choice but to be his wife.
Yeah, there are no choice no choice.
How can you force marriage?
Exactly, that's what I'm talking about. No choice.
There's no choice.
The beginning, look, if you go.
Marriage is forced.
It's forced, it's an enemy.
But it doesn't say that.
Because it says you can marry her. It doesn't say she has
a choice. Because it says that she has a will. No, okay. Listen, if you have no choice, if she had no choice, yeah, he would marry her regardless. That means she has no will at all.
If the verse says, it's up to him.
No. The verse says, yeah, if she doesn't want to, or if he's not pleased with her, yeah, then she can go her way.
That's later.
That's later. I can't believe these guys.
If she says, no, I don't want to marry you, she has the will
but
to not marry
him. For 30 days, she has to stay with him.
Of course she has to. She's a captive.
But she doesn't want. What if she doesn't want?
How do you know that she does?
No.
To be a captive, to be a slave in the Bible, to be a captive. Yeah, you can be under someone's roof. They can provide for you.
No. This is different. Look, this is
that's in the Bible.
We are talking about.
This
is what we're talking about. Captives.
That's how the Bible talks about. Yes. And when we think about slavery,
guess your captives.
Oh my God, but anyway, we are actually talking about this subject.
Can you read that? You're not understanding.
I've read it already.
It's a captive, an enemy.
Why in Islam? I want you to see that.
Let's not deviate.
It makes
sense. No, it doesn't matter.
I'm asking you to define captive and enemy.
Yeah, exactly.
Define both of them.
No.
Captive and enemy. What does that mean?
Captive and enemy.
You're an enemy, and I get you captive. Now you have no choice. I can marry you if I want to, but if you don't, if you say no, tough. What is that? Is that forced?
It's not forced at all.
I can't believe that. After they killed the husband, the mother, and the all children, the family, and the children,
and you're forcing
these people are so.
You kill the husband, and you find her attractive, and then you can marry her, whether she likes it or not.
You can choose to.
Let's not read this again. These guys are something. You're understanding. Sorry, not what?
It doesn't say husband.
You can marry, right?
No, but it doesn't say if she's married or not.
It just says just kill the husband and keep.
Listen to me. Let me read it. I tell you what. This is Deuteronomy, the same Deuteronomy, 10 to 11. But we have to go back to Deuteronomy 20:10-14. Yes. Let's go back now.
Same one again.
The same one before. That's it. Yeah. The husband has been killed. All the people have been killed. Let me read that.
Yeah, okay.
No, you people are. So listen. No, we just quoted Deuteronomy 21. 10 to 11. We have to go to 20.
He said, where's the husband?
No, listen. I'm going to tell you what. We know why the husband. No, we have to go back. Same thing. The same thing. Talking about the same war. The same people. He said, when you march up to attack a city, make its people an offer of peace. If they accept and open the gates, all the people in it shall be subject to forced labor and shall work for you. If they refuse to make peace and they engage you in battle, lay siege to that city. When the Lord your God delivers it into your hand, put to the sword all the men in the city. As for the women, the children, livestock and everything else in the city, you may take this as plunder for yourselves. And you may use the plunder the Lord your God gives you from your enemies. You understand?
You understand that?
Now when you come to that, this one here now, 21, what he said to you now, 21 said here now, when you go to war against your enemies, the same thing, and the Lord your God delivers them into your hand, and you take captives. Remember?
They're captive women, remember?
If you notice among the captives a beautiful woman, and are attracted to her, you may take her as your wife. When you go to the other, what happened? What did he say? When he said, if they don't want to accept peace, what do you do?
So you like that?
Keep all the men in the city.
Yeah.
But when this person takes as a wife, becomes a husband to that person.
But for the children and the plunder, take all.
Sex slave. You can have sex with your slave. That's what the Quran says.
You attack Islam, slave on the Bible. They don't know. That's it. Is he taking the woman against her will?
Of course.
So right. She's a sex slave.
But
does she have a right to leave?
It doesn't actually say that.
Did you read the verse? You didn't read the verse?
30 days.
30 days, yeah.
Yeah.
And she has the right to leave.
30 days, she has to be forced into marriage.
And she still has the right to leave.
But 30 days forced marriage is fine, right?
It's not forced marriage, though.
But she doesn't have a choice. Marriage.
She has no choice.
She doesn't have no choice. She has a choice.
What choice?
She's given 30 days to mourn. Okay,
I cannot believe it. That's
the
thing.
Tomorrow for what?
That's it. Tomorrow for what? What's he mourning for? Tell me.
Can you marry me?
What's he mourning for?
Another day.
What's he
mourning for? What's he mourning for? That's a part of the Jewish law. When a woman cuts off the hair,
what are they mourning for?
What are they mourning for?
For our parents, obviously.
What happened to the parents? People.
They got killed, yes.
And they killed the parents.
Yeah. And they're forcing them to shave their hair off as well.
Who forced them to shave their hair?
Read it.
It's a custom that they
look,
do.
You kill a woman's mother, a father, and children, and have everything, and you force her to marry her.
Islam, when you have your sex slaves, what do? To them, you go into them, they're not even your wife, you just have sex with them, rough. They're even against their will, that's in Islam. So in the Bible, at least it has morality. You can have, you can marry her, she can become your wife.
Forced marriage.
And in Islam, you can have sex and have sex with them. And the women against
forced
their will.
Marriage is morality.
You can kill their husbands. You can kill their husbands.
This is forced marriage.
Sex with them on the same
this
day.
Is forced marriage.
Does it say forced marriage?
This is forced marriage.
What does it say?
I'm telling you. Where does it say
that? Show us where it says forced marriage.
Ain't no forced marriage.
I don't know how many times I'm going to read to you.
Really?
There's no forced marriage. You women's allowed to leave. Would Mama Muhammad let any of the sex slaves leave?
So why is she could leave if he's not free? If it's forced.
So the woman was priest. You mean they killed the woman's husband? Killed the
mother and father.
Kill the father, the mother, everything. Somebody, she must have lost a family member or friends or relative in that fight. Yeah, she's mourning.
It's your religion. Defend it. I'm making statements.
You're making the accusation. Show me the proof.
I don't need to know.
Your Bible says, no, no, proof all things. No, we've got to prove that. Quran is there. Hold on.
So you make an accusation and I should prove it.
So, okay, I'm going to ask you. Muhammad,
you're making an accusation.
No, our Quran is there. Your Quran is there. Your Quran is
did Muhammad have sex with his sex slave? Did Muhammad have sex with his sex slave?
Your Honor,
did Muhammad have sex with his sex slave?
Did Muhammad have sex with his sex slave?
He doesn't know nothing.
Did Muhammad have sex with his sex slave?
No answer.
Did Muhammad have sex with his sex slave?
What is the proof?
So yes or no?
What is the proof then?
I don't see no no.
I said no.
He said no.
No.
I said no.
No.
Okay. Yes. Show the proof. I love that.
Yeah.
So now you're gonna prove your mom.
So what's the big deal?
What was your thing, Lamin? What did you say in Christianity?
No, I quoted verses from the Bible about slavery, about forcing women against their will to marry them, against their will, to take captives.
My brother, Jesus said, never come out. See they see not, hear they hear not, neither do they understand.
That's the thing.
That's
your Bible.
It's there.
Do that hadith for them, please.
Yeah, that's what I'm getting.
You Christian?
I can prove Christianity in Christ.
correct?
Yeah.
I can prove it from your own Bible. And you're saying do that hadith for him? Brother. Yeah? Yeah. You didn't say do the Quran for him.
Brother. No, because the hadith
from their own Bible. I can prove their Christianity is incorrect. We Muslim, no matter what happened, who is sect, we take Quran as the final book. We believe Prophet Muhammad is the last prophet. And we believe Allah is one. They believe God is in three. They believe God is one. They believe Jesus only Messiah. They believe Joseph is the last prophet. They believe, look, how many different beliefs they have. They used to believe in early part of the Christianity, good God, bad God. Then 380 become three. Now you see, this is called paganism. Christianity is not true.
So what about kissing the stone?
Kissing the stone. Okay, what's your point on that?
So that is just, did anyone do that before Muhammad?
Yes, they did. Abraham did.
As per your, anyone after Abraham?
Anyone after Abraham?
Yeah.
Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because of the path of the Quraysh, he continued that. Do you understand?
Okay, anyone else?
What else are you talking about?
Any Arab people who weren't Muslim?
No.
They didn't. So the Arabs didn't kiss the
Muslim? No, are you talking about the pagan?
Huh?
Are you talking about the pagan?
Yeah.
No, pagan was not, that time the stone was not there. Okay, answering your question.
Mm.
When you have a cross in your neck or in the car, not you, many Christians, when they say, Christomo, they go to the Orthodox Christian.
That's Catholic.
The Catholic, I mean the Orthodox Christian as well, in Greece, in Cyprus, in Russia. Oh Lord, that you're the God. What they're praying to? They're praying to the wood, or they're praying to the God?
Yeah, but they're not Israelites, so I don't really care about
them. But the mother, they're Christians.
They're different. Look.
No, according to you, not according to me.
Very good point you raised.
Mm?
Very good.
Mm-hmm.
So, my point valid.
Mm.
Another sect, Israelite, not Christian, Israelite, then Kemet, all of them, Mormon, Jehovah's Witness, different belief. You know that, if you go to the history of the Christianity, first 100 years, they had at least 3 different beliefs. They used to believe one good God, bad God, because the Old Testament was bad, and Jesus, when he came, he became good. So that cannot be reconciled. They said, good God, bad God.
You seem to have diverted. We're talking about the
cover. I am coming to my point that Christianity is not correct.
Right.
Because you have 20 different beliefs. We, as a Muslim, always believe, Kul hu Allahu ahad, Allah is one. Kul hu Allahu ahad. Sorry, Kul hu Allahu da, Allahu samad, lam yalid walam yulad, walam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. That always been to.
What
makes you think that your Allah is the same as our God?
Did I say that?
Do you agree?
Did I say that? Have I said that?
Okay, good. So you disagree? We don't worship the same God, yeah?
No, you.
Do we worship the same God?
Are you having a conversation?
Yeah.
Okay, let me tell you this. I was telling this brother that Christianity is not correct. Because, hear me out.
Yeah.
If you have objection, come to it then.
Okay.
Because when Jesus passed away, there was two. When
according to you, according to
you,
according to the Bible,
there was a two sects, three different sects of belief. One is to believe the good God and the bad God. Because the Old Testament was where God was punishing innocent baby, infant. Child being raped, homosexuality, it cannot be good God.
Child being raped?
Yeah.
Where?
Don't you
know? Yeah, bring that one.
I'll give it to you, everything. Everything is recorded.
No, but you
I'll give it to you.
In fact, you said it.
No, I'll give it to you.
Okay.
Everything I'll give it to you.
It's talking about the laws of rape in the Bible. There's a law about rape. When you rape a woman,
he's a child.
No, maybe, yeah. maybe.
I want the child.
I said,
I am telling you that Christianity is had division. And
okay,
hear me out, brother. I didn't make the point. We had a God who was a good God, which is New Testament, bad God in Old Testament.
Who told you that?
No, there's a sect that believed that. Yeah, there was. I've read about it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
We'll discuss this when you know this.
Go ahead, tell me.
Then you have 3D.
Have we got the proof yet?
This
is for the slavery,
No, he's saying that Muslims keep women as sex slaves.
Where? Show me where.
According to him. According to him. I'm still waiting.
Muslims at all like, oh, where did this say this?
Brother, bring it.
You all know this, man. Come on, man. It's sex slaves even in your country, man. Stop pretending and stuff, man.
He said what?
Wait a second. You know what? You know what you're getting mixed up, yeah? What you're getting mixed up is the Arabs before. The Arab before pre-Islam,
exactly,
and the Muslim, you know, after that, exactly. Did you know that
in our book,
the old days,
there's no word called rape. If there's anything like that, I'll become a Christian tonight.
The girls,
show me anywhere in the rape.
So now you're gonna tell me,
not a rape in their book, rape.
Rape is that, yeah.
Incest, homosexuality.
It just tells you the.
So God says to do.
Incest is there.
Muhammad
God doesn't say this kind of thing.
No. God gives
in Bible, on testimony.
In the Bible, God gives a lot of rape. When a man rapes a woman, he tells what a man. When a man rapes a woman, rape, he gives a law. What should happen? You know,
brother.
You know, I just had a conversation with what's his name? Keep forgetting his name.
Hashim.
No, the other one.
Shamsim.
No, the next one.
Have you found a proof yet?
Like, so
Adnan.
No. He was here today. Mansoor. That's it. I had to explain it to him, same thing. The word, if you read your Bible and look in the Hebrew, it's a different word. So the translation isn't correct.
Show the proof. What is Aramaic? So what do they mean?
No, it's originally written in Hebrew.
So is that same verse? Same verse?
Yeah.
So what is the same verse I'm talking about? Loss of rape.
Yeah.
They come and regurgitate these lies and then figure out they're telling the truth.
Surah 424, have you read that as well?
Surah 424. Yeah, what did he say?
And forbidden to you are the wedded wives of others except those who are holding your hands. Those who are prisoners of war, yeah?
You ready? For what? We're going to have some food.
Yeah?
Go have some food. Come next week.
All right.
Come next week, bro.
Let's come.
No, I've got to go home because I've got work tomorrow.
What food do we get you?
Now you've got an opportunity now to talk to him.
Yeah, but I have to hear what he says.
You know what this is called, ad hominem
stuff? I just want to have a discussion. What's Hashim doing here so late? He normally runs off early.
I didn't agree. I said there's a condition. Unless and until
you're in your condition, you're poor. Yes.
That is the most important thing. In a time,
you organize the hash every year for you.
In a time,
you're group 4
is. It's good to get a discussion, dialogue, without standing over each other.